continuing coffee collection for the elementary school is still going on, but you need to bring everything in by next Sunday so we can deliver it to them. Our practice on Tuesdays at 6, our Bible study is Wednesday morning at 10 a.m. Coffee cup is Thursday morning at 10 a.m. And then our usual ones, we have a couple that are not in the bulletin. This Friday night, we have planned a game night at 6 o'clock. Everyone's welcome to come, bring your games, whatever you want to play. And also, if you want snacks or drinks, just bring something with you and we'll share. And then on Ash Wednesday, which is on Valentine's Day, February 14th, at 7 o'clock, we will have an Ash Wednesday service, not just coming in for communion and your ashes and leaving, but we'll have an actual service at 7 o'clock. Are there any other announcements, Jess?
If they want just ashes and communion, Houston will have it from 4 to 6.
Yes.
And it will just be ashes and communion.
If you want just ashes and communion, you can go down to Houston. They're doing it from 4 to 6. Anything else? Go ahead.
If everybody can start saving their grocery bags for the yard sale, we appreciate it. It's the first weekend of April, so it'll be here before we know it. And so we'll need bags. So
save your grocery bags for the rummage sale. It's on the 1st of April. Anything else? Then if you could be in an attitude of prayer, do a prayer with me, please.
Thank you.
here this morning. She called about 8 o'clock. She wasn't feeling well. She thought maybe she was getting the flu. So we're just going to have a hymn sing during the sermon time. You want to be thinking of some hymns you might like to sing. And now if you'll join me in the call to worship found in your bulletin. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told to you from the beginning?
The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of heaven and earth.
God sits above the circle of the earth and stretches out the heavens like a curtain.
Those who wait for the Lord shall mount up with wings like eagles.
They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
How good it is to praise to our God.
Now, if you turn in your hymnals to page 526, what a friend we have in Jesus. Everlasting God,
You stretch the sky over our heads like a canopy filled with twinkling lights. Scarcely do the stems of our lives take root before you carry us away by sorrow. Yet you care for us, healing the brokenhearted, gathering the outcast, lifting the downtrodden, while casting the wicked to the ground. Renew our strength this day, O God, that we may mount up with wings like eagles. Amen.
Our first scripture this morning comes from Isaiah 40, verses 21 through 31. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to live in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth as nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth, when he blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me, or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these. He who brings out their hosts and numbers them, calling them all by name, because he is great in strength, mighty in power, not one is missing. What do you say, O Jacob? And speak, O Israel. My way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youth will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Thus ends our first scripture reading for this morning. Could I have an usher, please? It's time for our offering. Thank you.
Wow.
Here they are, so you guys can see them prior to, because I think it's important to see them before you. Okay, you know what they look like. Now, do you know how they're made?
No.
Would you like to, you know how they're made? How are they made?
So what do we get? We get something special on the Sunday before Easter. What do we get?
No, that's not it. That's not these ones, at least.
Oh.
Do you do different ones?
Oh, I know. They burn wood.
No. Well, they do burn wood for the ashes, but these are made from palms. So you know how we have Palm Sunday? Where do we celebrate? We ride the donkey. And why do we ride the donkey? Why do we ride the donkey? Jesus rode the donkey. And what did the people put on the ground in front of him? And what did they shout?
Everybody's coming.
Hosanna. They shout Hosanna.
Well, if you sing, it's Hosanna.
They take the palm branches and they make these ashes, and we have them on Ash Wednesday.
Okay. So, what is after ash? So, once we take the ashes, do you know what we do after that? Well, after we, that's receiving ashes. So, what happens after that? We go into. There it is. Now, somebody had a question. Tori, would you like to tell everybody what your question was this year or today or this week?
Yeah.
Okay. So, we had to call Miss Jess because there was a question. It's leap year this year. Do you think we get an extra day off?
No.
41 days, guys. We're get that extra day. So, we are going to be in Lent for 41 days of faithfulness. Now, do you know why we do 40 days of Lent? Anybody?
Jesus.
He was in.
And he was tempted.
And he was tempted by the devil. You know what I think was the craziest temptation he had? Was the rocks.
What?
What did he do?
They had like loaves of bread.
Yeah. Bread, yeah. So, do you know what else faithfulness comes with? A God-given talent. And do you know what we're supposed to do with our God-given talents? We're supposed to use them on a daily basis because when we use them, they get better. So I'm going to have Miss Jess read you Hebrews 11, 1 through 3.
Now faith is the assurance of things, so things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Indeed, by faith, our ancestors received approval. By faith, we understand that the worlds were prepared by the word of God, so that what we see was made from things that are not visible.
Okay.
Very short.
It was. So, do you know when Jesus went to the wilderness?
Years ago.
Perfect. He went right after he was baptized. He went straight out there. It was so he knew this was it. This was it. So, most people give up things for Lent. And I'm not. I'm going in with a whole new mindset. I'm going in with an attitude of gratitude. An attitude of gratitude. It's being grateful. grateful for being one of God's children, even though I'm middle-aged. But I have a very, very confident feeling that everybody shares that with me that's in this building. And I can tell you, since I've joined this church, everybody has given me a wow moment. And do you know what that is? It's they have given me a moment that they have made me feel so special that I am the only person that matters in that second in their life. Isn't that pretty cool? Yeah. Yep. Yeah, Beatitudes. But you know what also they taught me? That a lot can happen in 3 days because Jesus made that happen. Did you see this? So last night I sat and I made you guys this. A lot can happen in 3 days. What is it? And my banana, which by the way, I thought this was funny last night when I came home. You buy bananas in bunches, but you can't try one. Like, you can try grape, see what I'm saying? But you probably would get frowned upon if you tried a banana when you get one other banana. But all of our bananas look the same, right? Well, I'm going to have faith if I try a banana later, I'm not going to get sick about it, right? But if you start looking, my banana is just a little bit different than their banana. See? But you always have to keep your faith. You know why? Because God is the most faithful person to you. Because we have such a beautiful God. See, because he's there every morning to turn the lights on. And he's there every morning, there every night to put the sun to bed and bring out the moon. Isn't that pretty cool?
Actually, the sun and the moon are asleep. So when it's me here, another second the world is dead.
Yes, you guys are so smart. So, I also think we have these, your face stones. So, if you ever need them, you just rub them, and we'll be right there for you, okay? All right, let's say a little prayer, all right? Thank you, God, for being such a beautiful God and giving us each our God-given talents to use every day. We have Miss Ruthie that uses her talent on the piano, and Miss Jess to use her talent to make the bulletins. And we have Miss Tammy back there that keeps her church running, and Miss Hazel too. And Miss Jess, who keeps track of our beautiful change and all the other stuff. Without these beautiful people, we would make this church go. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And this story for our wonderful communion bread, but we have it.
Thank you.
sharing of our joys and concerns. Bless you.
Thank you.
Does anybody have anything they want to share with us? A concern or a joy? Beth?
I got a message from Barb Pinter yesterday. Rich's nephew, John Shipley, he's 72 years old, passed away. He had heart issues. So she asked if we could put them all on the prayer list.
Okay.
And
Shipley?
Shipley, yeah.
The Shipley family, which is Rich Kinder's nephew, passed away from heart issues.
And then Joel and Anthony?
Yes, and this week my brother-in-law will be having injections into his back. He has severe pain all the time, and they're hoping that this will help. Tori?
I might get a corgi puppy.
I might get a corgi puppy. Are you praying really hard for that?
Yeah. I also got some good news this week about Elon, where she really would like to go to school. So she has to go down there the first week of March to interview, to try and get in her accelerated program so she can get a master's and her bachelor's at the same time. So if you all say a prayer, I'm sure God already has a plan, but she wants to go there with $60,000 a year. So if they don't offer up some money, she won't be going. So let's just all hope that works. Whatever way it's supposed to go.
If God lets her know what her path is supposed to be. Okay.
Nina, my friend Robin is home, and he's got to adjust to new life, but he got word that there's going to be more testing because it was what they feared it would be. So prayers as he goes forward, adjusting to the new life.
Nina's friend Robin is home, but he's facing more tests, and doesn't sound like they're real hopeful about the outcome. So he still needs our prayers. Jen?
One of my staff members, Ann, had this was her second bout with breast cancer. She had a double mastectomy, and they don't think they got it all, so now she's supposed to have chemo and radiation.
One of Jen's workers that's had a double mastectomy and now has had cancer, chemo and radiation. Ann, you said? Yeah. Jen? Jess?
First for a mom, she hasn't had her kids. Dad goes to a cardiologist surgeon on Thursday this week. So just hopes that they tell us, okay, surgery's way off in the future.
Okay. Any other prayers, concerns?
Hey, I got a call last night from a lady in her community. Another lady just moved here, and she went into congestive heart failure last night, and they took her to the hospital. The new lady in our community, her name's Sandy, and the other lady just asked to keep her in our prayers.
Sandy, who's in congestive heart failure, went into the hospital. She just moved into our community.
Oh, and I forgot, in my children's room, I have lollipops for everybody for their wow moment.
We get a wow moment. Lollipops in a bucket down there. I thought I saw lollipops. Any others? Then let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us here together today. Our church family is so important to us, and we thank you for each and every one of them. We thank you for the sunshine that we're seeing outside and the warm temperatures that we're supposed to have, though I think you're spoiling us because it's still winter time. We thank you for all the blessings that you give us, Father, for our homes, for our families, our friends, everything that you give to us that we wouldn't have without you. Father, you've heard all of the names that we've lifted up to you. You know their needs better than we do. Please be with each and every one of them. And provide the care that they need. And now, Father, we pray the prayer that your Son Jesus taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. turn in your faith missing, the little black book, page 2244. People need the Lord. Cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. A preaching tour in Galilee. In the morning, while it was still very dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also. For that is what I came out to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
And now, if you'll turn to page 881 in your hymnals, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and he sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Okay, the time to the place where it's time for the sermon, and singing can bring a sermon. So, who has a song they'd like to sing? We've got three hymnals to pick from. Sandy?
In the Garden.
In the Garden. Page.
You know, I'll stop your ready.
314. 314. Thanks, Brenda. We'll sing the first and the last verse of each of the songs.
Thank you.
first and the fourth. We'll do first, take the first and the fourth, and take that last one. First ending with the first, and then the second ending with the second first. You all got that?
Yeah.
Just keep it.
Thank you. wand.
Jesus.
What's that?
Here, Psalms 347.
347 in your name.
Oh,
593.
The story to tell to the nations. There's a river.
thee. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace.